Yes, he's one of the most popular recording artists of all time and a true rock and roll legend. Tonight he's performing a song for his current CD, Fate of Nations. This is his very first time on The Tonight Show. Please welcome Robert Plant.
Tears at the water's end. Hey, little sister, give us laughter instead. Tears for the teacher, from the eyes, from the soul. This restless spirit takes a long way back home. No more. Like the wind, you are free. Just a whisper, I hear you, so talk to me. Say, but a sister, see your brother in the sky. Neighbor, neighbor, don't be so cold. There's so much glory in the story I'm told.
Currently touring the country now, eh?
Yep, this is our 14th country.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Boy.
Really?
Now, how long are you for, a year or something like that?
With any luck, yeah. Hopefully, maybe two.
So how often do you get home in the course of a tour like that? Or you don't? You just...
There isn't a... Home is where the heart is, you know?
Yeah, but where's the mail? I mean, when you go home...
I mean, how do you... It's not the mails I'm bothered about, really. we've been traveling for... I think our first show was May the 1st in Rome. And we've been through Czechoslovakia, all over Europe. And then we finally got here about 3 weeks ago.
Because, see, I would go out on tour, but you'd, like, fly home once a week, once every 10 days, and just sort of, you know, dump the laundry and then grab fresh laundry and go out again. But you must, it's just cases and cases.
Oh, no, you send it all back to that address in England.
Oh, I see.
Just, saying, just, oh, that's dirty, that better go now.
Just piles up.
Yeah.
So you first came to the States when? I guess it would be, what, 69?
December 68.
Oh, 68, okay. and went swung through Boston, my hometown.
That's right. Yeah.
What was your first impression when you came here? It's a bit odd.
Well, we got here the day before Christmas, 1968, and it was just, I think it was LAX. So the building, I mean, in England, architecture hasn't been born yet, you know? Or rather, if it was, it died with King Arthur. So Americans go and they go to England, they go, how quaint, but nothing works.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Our streets are crap,
right.
And the whole place is falling down. So LAX, policemen with guns, and then the Strip, and the Whiskey A-Go-Go, and the ladies.
Yeah.
The ladies.
Fine. This seems to be a recurring theme, the ladies.
But for all entertainers, or?
No, for you.
Oh, yeah,
it seems to be a recurring theme.
I've been very lucky.
How different are the audiences now from 68, 69? I mean, is it much? Enthusiasm.
I think I came in at the end of the hippie trip.
Yeah.
I guess so, and I was very inspired by the whole West Coast American scene. I thought it was really, the music, what was being put across was really strong. In England, we were always concerned with what went on below the belt, you know.
Yeah,
whereas over here, there was a lot of cerebral stuff going on. It was great to be here. It was really good, and I miss to a degree the kind of innocence of the music then.
Yeah,
you know.
Yeah.
I think there's a lot of fakery going on right now. There's a lot of retro stuff. There's some interesting music, but I must say, back then, I have some good
memories. But this seems to be coming back, all this unplugged stuff, and everybody just sort of doing the pure...
Yeah, but it's a bit cheesy now, in a way, you know? Because, I mean, how can you unplug some of these artists? It's not, you know, I mean, why am I saying this? Because it could ruin my career completely.
No. So what you're saying is...
I mean, really, I think... I'll probably end up doing it in 2 months' time.
Yeah, there you are. So what you're saying is these kids today, they don't know what the hell they're
talking
about.
Oh, no. All they do, we just been playing with some great people.
I know. You going to do Talk Cool One when we get back?
I'd love to.
Okay, right back. Paul with Robert Plant. Hey. All righty. Hey, Branford. Robert, tell Branford what you just told me.
Yeah, well, in the break, I was saying we spent all our lives as musicians in England trying to sound like black guys from Chicago. And then suddenly, the tables are turned and now you're sounding like Led Zeppelin. I think that's great.
Thank you. Equality for everyone.
All right, tomorrow night on the program, Emilio Estevez will be here, fitness fanatic Susan Powder, and the music of Billy Dean. Friday from Saturday Night Live, Rob Schneider, Mr. October himself, Reggie Jackson will be here, and Donna Summer. And upcoming weeks are Anthony Hopkins, Katie Sagal, Governor Ann Richards, Nicole Kidman, Phil Collins, Julia Louis-Dreyfus from Seinfeld, the Lemonheads, and a gentleman I've been trying to get for a long time, and today he said yes, the Governor of New York, Mr. Mario Cuomo. Wow. So we're very excited about that. Be right back with Danny Aiello right after this. So.
He's a great kid, and I'm very happy.
Oh, there you go. Oh, good. Yeah, that's very exciting. Thanks. Now, you've been married, you've been here almost 40 years.
I've been married 30, and I'll be 39 years January 8th.
Oh, there you go.
We got married very young.
Yeah.
You learn anything in that?
Same woman. Look at it. It rubs off. Watch out,
Robert. No, I managed 14 years, and I think I was only there for 12. What? Well, no, 2 years out of 14.
Well, you travel a lot. That's why.
Yeah.
Fortunately.
Well, you travel a lot. Does your wife travel?
She travels with me. We have problems. You know, yeah. Sandy.
Okay, performing Tall, Cool, and welcome back, Robert Plant. us, Danny Aiello, who opens in Breaking Legs, a play in Chicago. Good luck to you, Danny. This is Fade of Nations, Robert Plant. Thanks, boss. Thanks for coming by. And, of course, George Foreman, thank you, sir. George, November 5th and 6th. Tomorrow night, Emilio Estevez, Fitness Fanatic Susan Powder, and the music of Billy Dean. So I'll see you tomorrow. Thanks, folks. Bye-bye.